Well, an aquatic biologist is aquatic, it just means water, and a biologist is someone who studies living organisms in their environment. So as a freshwater aquatic biologist, that would be someone who studies these organisms in the waters here in like a creek right like this, or a river or a stream. Okay, a typical day for me as a freshwater aquatic biologist was I would load up all my equipment and I would drive to the creek that I was going to be assessing. And first I would take field parameters. And that's like measuring your dissolved oxygen, your temperature, your pH, your conductivity. And next I would look at the habitat. I would look at the riparian zones, and that's the edges and the banks of the creek where the water meets the land. And I would see, do I have natural trees, bushes, and grass growing there? I'd look at the landscape. And then lastly, I would go through that reach of stream and collect my benthic macroinvertebrates. And I would go through all of those that I found and make a list. So when I'm done, I look at my field parameters, my habitat, and my creek critters, and I could tell you if that stream was healthy or not. Okay. I became an aquatic biologist by, well, first of all, when I was younger, I just liked being outdoors and I liked all different kinds of animals. So I actually got a 4-year degree as a wildlife biologist. And then what happened is when I got out of college, I was hired by the state to be an aquatic biologist. So they kind of trained me on the job and helped focus me just into the aquatic area. And so that is how I became an aquatic biologist. I did have that 4-year degree, and it was necessary to get my job. Okay, some of the skills you might need as an aquatic biologist is you want a good sense of observation when you're out and looking at things around you. You need to be able to like learn to identify things, certain critters. I had to learn to identify aquatic macroinvertebrates. You want to have some organizational skills because you have to plan on, for my job, I had to plan on different creeks that I wanted to go to and different areas that I wanted to cover. So another skill you would have is the ability to be able to write up your observations into a format that is understandable and can relay your scientific data. Okay, well, there were many great things that happened to me out in the field. I just love being out in the field. But one special occasion was I was sitting by a creek, kind of like this. I was sitting on the bank and there was a lot of jewelweed around me, and this other natural vegetation growing around. And I was looking down and I was writing up my report. And I was so intent in writing up what I just found, my creek critters and all, I hadn't noticed there was this buzzing all around my ears and my head. And so I looked up and I was surrounded by hummingbirds. They had moved in to feed on that jewelweed around me, and they were just all around me, flying all around me. So I just stayed real still. I think they thought I was just part of the landscape because I'd been so still before. And I just waited there and watched them. They finished feeding and then off they flew.
If you like learning about nature, an aquatic biologist is not your only option for a career. You could study forests and become a forester, or study oceans and become a marine biologist. You could even study insects if you want and become an entomologist. There are so many options when it comes to studying the natural world, and the world needs more young people to become scientists to help us understand more about the world around us. Or, if you decide to do something else, like own a business or be an artist, you can help support the environment through your career as well.